controversial lady. She's a very controversial lady, and she goes by the name Kiki. Do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave. I don't know if she gets mad when we sing along that song, or, you know, call her by that song instead of, you know, just saying Kiki. Did you even know that Drake was going to sing a song about you?
Of course, no. It's not about me. It's many Kikis out there. I can't get mad. It's Drake. Come on.
Yeah, but the whole Kiki, you know, Kiki is always causing, and you have also been causing a stir in the music industry here in the country. So tell us a bit about who is Kiki and what does she do and where did she even come from?
Kiki bedesi kiki ile ki Tanzania ati napenda kiki lakini wajua lazima kiki ndio uendelee in life. Me, I'm from county 001 Mombasa, Makande to be specific. Bigger watu wangu wa Makande, Shimanzi, Makupa, Chuda. Na nilianza rap. I didn't start hip hop cause ati I was passionate at first. I hated hip hop lakini msoto na life drove me to rapping because you're like, sasa, what is my talent? Life ikinilemea, ama ni made kampon, hakuna job. Ndafanya nini? Sezi result to drugs, sezi result to whoring. Wacha nikuwe rapper, wacha niandike mistari.
Maze.
Ujui itakupeleka wapi? Naam.
Na unajiita lyrical genius. How did you even come up with such a word? I mean, of course, you never used to like rap, you never used to like hip-hop, so how did you even find passion in this? You've said ume ulikuna hustle, blah, blah, but how do you even come up with lyrical genius? What drives you?
Lyrical genius, as in ukisikiza mistari zangu, you'll want to hear, even if you don't know me, you'll ask yourself, who's that girl? I'm also the Kenyan Tupac.
Hey, female Tupac. You don't say.
Yes. So, me, I can say that I have very witty lyrics. That's why I'm the lyrical genius, yeah.
All right. So this is not your first time at Y254, that's for sure.
Yeah.
You've kujad here before, and we really enjoyed your interview. However, you said you started music in 2014.
Yeah.
But you were a Konda somewhere.
Yes.
Line gani, area code EP.
Shout out to Watu Ongwaro 46, Apo Ambassador, Metro Sacco. Nilikuwa Donda hapo, hapo ndio imenijenga na hii hustle ya Nairobi. Naweza sema, yeah.
Cheki, kuna madema hapa unajua anajifanya kazi tu ni masponyo, kuingisha M-Pesa after every month. I mean, look at you doing...
Ni uvivu.
Yeah.
One, you're lazy. And two, unaona haya. Unaonea kazi yako haya. Like, what will people say if they see me here? What will? And utaenda mahali with what people will say. People will take you nowhere. Yeah.
Haya, cheki. Umekuwa ukithrow malines kwa female, other FMCs in the country.
Which ones?
Akina. Hey, really?
Najiona mimi. Nani mwingine?
Hey, unataka tuanze kutaja hapa.
Unajua hiyo, ilikuwa kitambo. Right now, I'm a brand. So, hata sioni mtu mwingine. Female rapper gani?
I really want to talk about Kukumwi too. Because, man, this. This.
So, unajua Kenya, lazima udis ndo utoke.
Why the word kuku alafu mwitu? Mi najua, najua nini, chipo mwitu, but sijaifikiria kuna kuku.
Kwani wewe umegrow up wapi? Uji kuku mwitu.
Zi, okay, wacha na.
Zile kuku za mtani za 25 bob,
really?
60 bob, kapaja kathate. Ewe.
No, surely, why kuku mwitu? Why come up with that?
Those are, the people I was addressing, they were like too local, too cheap, too ratchet, ndomana kwa kuku mwitu. Like, I had to use a catchy title because wa Kenya ningeita like, for example, rap, ama niite a big name, wa Kenya wouldn't care. Lakini nikita madondo, kuku mwitu, sponyo, wataangalia. So, yeah, I was looking at the Kenyan market because before that, kwame tuangoma, yo sisi ndo hao, my demo sita, it didn't get much response. But I was like, Kenyans, I know. Nikita takomba mwiko ngoma mtaskiza.
So, cheki, uliko natusi madem fulani hapo. Umewa forgive, it's 2019 ama...
Hakuna beef, unajua hip-hop iko hivyo. It's just the game. As long as I don't know you personally, I can't hate on you personally. Lakini kama uko wak, usitari hati ndakubembeleza kama unachezwa. I'll call you out, talk hapo kwa game.
Anyway, alright, there's something I noticed about your interviews and also your songs. I don't like comparing artists, but your dressing is different for a female rapper. Like, for example, you know, Msupaesa alikuja hapa na even Noti Flo. I think she's a friend or something.
No.
In the industry.
No.
Okay. Hey, all right.
No.
Shots fired. Before they're fired, let me stop them. Anyway, so Noti Flo dresses in very, you know, showy clothes.
They have nothing else to offer. Simple.
Yeah.
Yeah, they want a mystery, they want a talent. Mm-hmm. So, for you to look at them, lazima angalie mwili alafu ndio hivyo. Lakini mimi nikiongea hivi, you'll have to listen to me.
For sure.
Yeah.
So, your dressing is very different and it's what cuts across, you know, from... Because you dress up in long dresses, long skirts, which is different for, you know...
Well, maybe I'll change. Unajua, binadamu...
Ubadilika.
Wacha pesa zinge vizuri. Maybe mimi nitaanza kuvaa kama Nicki Minaj na Cardi B.
All right, so speaking of Cardi and Nicki Minaj, who's your, like, international, frontier? Who's your international
Kendrick
frontier?
Lamar.
Kendrick Lamar.
Oh, my God. And there's another one called IMDDB.
Yo,
you know about, IMDDB?
I was about to compare you with that lady because I was listening to your songs last night and I'm like, wait, this girl sounds like
IMDDB. She is my number one. Oh, my God. She is my number one she inspires me. In mm-hmm. fact, my growth, if you ukiangalia ngoma zangu before na sahi, nimegrow sana. Mm-hmm. Na ni yeye ameinspire flow yangu.
Especially the one that is, you umeimba sahi, the one that you just dropped right now, Safi.
Yeah.
Safi is more like IMDDB vibes.
Thank you.
Have you borrowed a scene from her? Because there's also a part where she's in a store and she's dancing and singing. And yeah.
No, you know, I got that place. Ilikuwa Southfield Mall, big up Southfield Mall. A Chinese shop. Mm-hmm. And I was looking for a location and I went there and the manager remembered me from Avocado.
Really?
And I got it for free. Yeah.
Anyway, kabla tujenda mbali from, you know, IMDDB and your inspirations and your international inspirations, I noticed that you took, you sampled a song from Kendrick Lamar's album, the inaitwaje Control.
Yes.
Uli
beat.
Beat. Why?
Kwa sababu, he also used it to diss. And I wanted to go hard like that. If Kendrick can use it to diss, let me use the same beat he used because he's my number one rap god. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, okay.
Ile kutasema nini, nimetumia the hardest beat, utasema nini kunihusu. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Cheki, tuingie play Kenyan music, hashtag play Kenyan music.
Yeah.
What's your take on play Kenyan music?
Play 95%.
Do you have a solution for us?
Solution ni ma DJ, ma producer, ma media personality, kila mtu achangamke. Si artist peke yake. Ati sisi tuende studio, si tulipe studio nini, bado tualipe nyinyi ati for airplay nini nini. Hapana, kila mtu anafaa achangamke. That's what I can say. Yeah. Kila mtu anafaa achangamke na watu waache kuchukulia issues personal. Like wewe, for example, there are artists and there are hosts. Just know your role. Don't compete with artists. Where's the celeb? Just do your work. At the end of the day, ujui msanii atatoka international, akwe nani, wewe bado utakuwa kwa hiyo station, bado una host. So I can say, don't take things personally because it's not up to you to decide what Kenyans want to listen to. Uki receive ngoma poa, wewe cheza. Wa Kenya wasipoipenda, acha kuicheza.
Lakini mimi sitabaki hapa forever.
Wengi ni hivyo, wengi ni hivyo. For example, mimi hivi nitoke hivi. I'm signed to an international label. Nitoke. Mm-hmm. Niende for example nifanye collab huko majuu. Unajua nitakuja nipate wale mapresenter wako pale pale wanani kiss. Wananikiss eh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because eventually you'll still look for me because media ni ile ile. But an artist can grow. Mm-hmm. You don't know my potential as an underdog. Yeah.
Oh yeah, tell us about your label. I mean, me nilikuwa nafanya ngoma back in 2011 and ile nilikuja Nairobi shamba la mawe. But you seem to be having a very easy life. Who's
it's
Black
not
Market?
Easy life. Unajua ningekuwa donda bado kama si label yangu. Mm. Sasa naweza sema tu yani kila siku talent lazima ijipe. Mm-hmm. If you keep on doing your thing and not listening to people, because people are your greatest enemies, by the way. Even your family can be your greatest haters, number one hater.
True that.
Even your boyfriend, and it's a kuku discourage.
Hey, yo, baby.
So nasema, yani wewe, just do your thing. Ukiamini, kuna siku utafika, but don't stop. Because mm-hmm. that's how I was discovered. Mm-hmm. If I gave up, nikisikiza, mazee kiki ya utaifika, mazee una do, mazee ni nini na nini, singe wa ito kwa discovered mm-hmm. na label yangu. Shout out to Black Market Records, California. Sacramento.
Oh, it's based in California.
Sacramento. Yay. Yeah. Right. See Calif. Mm. California.
California. Yeah. Yes. See like California. So I'm looking at an upcoming artist who's trying to get inside into a label or, you know, sign contracts and all that. How do you go about signing a label? How do you go about?
I swear it can be depressing, my friend. Woo! Can be depressing. Neza sema tu kila mtu akona wakati wake. Sasa you have to trust the process. Mm-hmm. Just do your thing, trust the process. Na opportunity, nasemi ati nikisema opportunity simanishi platform. Ati usketi, wapi siju kuna show, wenda kuperform free, wenda kuperform, usi perform free. Hey, platform ni ile ni ukiona opportunity, like there's something really concrete, ani unajua hapa, kuna kitu ineza come out of it, irukie. Mm-hmm. Hey, even unaweza sema.
Hey, all right, wuna kakupika maneno, Joe. Na... So, tukiongelea story ya kupika, you mentioned that you cook somewhere.
In Swahili, come on.
I know. So, how is your pilau? I'm a lover of pilau, by the way.
Abu's
place, apa jamia, hi. So, ungeniletea kiasi for real?
Lakini saini ya subuhi, na pika pilau ya subuhi, unless ya jana ni ipa kuika iwom.
Oh, so jana ulipika pilau, I can
jana
come over.
Jana ndoma.
But is it tasty? I just want to know if your food is tasty.
Kwani sasa napika pilau kila siku.
Yeah, kwa sababu washasema wewe
sasa. Naishi bara, acha nikule nduma kidogo, matoke, mokimo, haya kesho biryani.
All right. So do you have any people in Kenya that you want to collab with in 2019? Let me it's a new year. People are doing great things. Nono meamka, you have released a new track, Juzi Juzi. So who are you looking forward to collaborate this 2019?
In Kenya, nobody really says I'm looking forward. Lakini yani mtu akinifuata na kazi yake ni poa. Doesn't matter kama unajulikana au hujulikaniwi. Me, I'm ready to work with you. Yeah. Sina ile ati lazima siju kwenani ndio nini. Au ambao wako na majina au tunaoita ma celeb. Wako down, ngoma zao ziko down. Most of them ni kuinsist tu kuchezwa. Lakini kuna wasanii who have talent. Na wako depressed back at home manake hawapati opportunity ya kusikika. Naam.
Hao wasanii unaosema unaongelea kuhusu calligraph ama?
Pia huyo. Same old. Like unajua hata kama wewe ni mkali, okay, unaweza kuwa number 1 leo. Lakini what will make you ubaki number 1? You have to keep on doing work, you have to grow, you have to be different. Sasa mimi nimeimba safi, alafu sasa nimekuja na Risa, so unaona ime a different vibe, na kuna nyingine inaitwa Papa, a different vibe. Like for example, like Kali, advise him, in fact atana na kizungu, maanake uwezi imba kizungu kuliko mzungu. Imba kijaka, rap na kijaka, man, utakili industry kabisa.
So do you have any respect for anyone in the Kenyan game right now?
I have respect for everyone who is putting in work, who's not
mention
giving
names
up.
We want names. Tunataka kura. We want names.
Kura. Aya, big up to I Foolish. Big up to Joe Face. Big up to myself.
Of course.
Nesema, big up to CMG. Big up to Django. Big up to LDC. Yani, wasani ni wengi sana. Ni venye tu? Naam.
Where do you get this vibrance, you know, if feeling, yeah, what's up, what's going on?
In life, you have to be like that, man. In this life, otherwise, utambulia patupu sahi, in this life, lazima uchangamke, lazima you have a voice, manake sahi ukiangali hakuna makazi. Kazi mara nyingi ni mdomo yako. Mimi nishaipata kazi kwa radio kwa sababu ya mdomo wangu nasema karatasi. Sasa nasema, lazima you be vibrant, lazima usikike, usikubali kuonewa ndio, uende mbele, usonge mbele, uliza Cardi B.
Lakini dems umehustle. You've been a radio host?
Yeah.
Where?
QFM.
Okay. How was it being a radio host? Na uko hapo unatuambia sisi ma presenter tutaishi hapa.
Sasa hizo ndo nilikuwa naanza. I wasn't that much of a rapper then. Kwa sijatoa, let me just say I wasn't stable. Lakini, yeah, it was a nice experience. I worked with Rashid Abdallah and Mogaka. Kabla QFM sasa iende chini kidogo.
Iyo tu.
Yeah, iyo tu radio show.
What do you think about female, unaonanga kama kuna female bullying in the music industry in Kenya?
Not bullying, but people don't want you utoke. People get mad when you work hard and not give up. Like, mbona una insist, mbona una work, mbona you keep, because I have to. You don't feed me, you won't support me, so I have to. You don't know me, you don't know what I can be. Mm-hmm. So, fanya yako, wacha mimi nifanya yangu. Don't get mad at me. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
tell us more about Avocado kabla tujengelea track yako. I know everybody is waiting for that new jam, but hold on. Tell us more about Avocado.
Avocado,
na
actually.
Jimbo no kulete Avocado yango because it is actually the season of avocados.
For real?
Yeah.
Na kuletea next time.
You better.
Sasa unajua nilitoa, at that time I was like, hey, ini season Femi plan alitoa namuita Femi plan alitoa this hiyo siku sikulala niliamka midnight nikapigia best yangu ambaye kwa na studio nikamwambia maze I have to record hii najua hii this hakuna mtu anaweza disc kuniliko kama ni kuenda hiki tu itaenda kuenda na kwenda nikamwambia I want another track I don't care if it's a demo don't master it just give me the way it is because I'll have to pay and I don't have money to pay so I took my kukumwitu and Avocado I went to my friend who had a camera kukumwitu twende graveyard Avocado twende kuna base nyingine imechafuliwa hapo so I was like he was like no let's just shoot kukumwitu we'll shoot Avocado another day I was like no I know you video directors mtaniruka maana ni kitu ya free utaniruka hebu nifanyie video mbili and ndio hivyo we did Avocado na ikaenda ikiendaga
you know no I think no let me upcoming artists you guys are missing yourselves if you ask me because people are out here doing things, yani forcing issues and making ways work. So at least you got something out of it. Haya, alafu sasa ngojea kabla after Avocado, tell us about Safi. Na sisi ndio hao. Ama tuanze na sisi ndio hao. Tuanze na sisi ndio hao sababu immediately after the dissing and all that,
it was before.
You ganged up. Oh, really?
It was before. I was angry because they didn't want to listen to Sisi Ndoao.
Oh.
Or have you seen six female rappers like that? That's like the dopest female track. Paka leo Kenya aye kwa na track dope ya ma rapper madame. So I was like, you're not listening to Sisi Ndoao. Kukumwitu, you must listen. Yeah.
But you see, you're a hard babe because I don't see how you can hate on a mama that you're still working with. That is Naughty Flow.
We weren't working with, like, Nile, producer ku approach. Kiki kuja kwa track. So anso kuja kwa track. Kwa so mkienda mnyote mko kwa track madame.
How's the feeling like mkishutio video?
Ilikuwa cool. Ilikuwa
zenyu hapo mnaonyesha vile y'all are doing nice. Like life is good. So far so good. But in the real sense, oh mtu anatoka hapo kama ame drop bars.
We were cool. Apana, in fact, hiyo sisi ndo hao, lines are naughty, aliandikiwa na Richie. Because Richie hako anaweza andika mistari.
Oh snap.
She normally has a ghostwriter.
Ha.
And she still work.
Exclusive right here on Y254.
Damn, how sad.
Digging up the dirt. Yes. Sorry though. Anyway, you mentioned that Kenyans are hypocrites.
Mm.
Why?
Cause mara nyingi we go for ratchet music. Anything that trends that is a bit ratchet or nudity or something, but when it's real talent, it's something concrete and serious, we give more attention to things that don't matter than the ones that matter. Yeah.
Okay.
But I think we'll change na media ikitupush the right way, na pia we have wasanii who are doing the right thing. So, si ati wa Kenya ni hypocrites, ni ile, kuna particular people wanapushiwa tu mziki. Lakini bado kuna mafans wengi sana in those people. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right.
I think it's just the product that the media pushes that makes Kenyans appear like they don't care about good music.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, guys, whether you care or not, she is dropping a new jam. She actually dropped a new jam 3 days ago, right?
Yep.
And it goes by the name Riswa. Yani, whatever your church does, your pastor does at church, that one. So why the word Riswa? Nini likufanya ukasikia hiyo siku?
Tunatoa mapepo.
Ulimemention Femi plan. Hey Femi one. Alitoa diss track, ukashindwa kulala, and then you went straight to the studio and you said this has to be ready by today and your videographer 1, 2, 3, this and this has to be shot by this and this day. So, Riswa, honestly, imetoka wapi? Hiyo moto imetoka wapi? Umekuja kuwa nani? Umekuja kutoment nani na hiyo Riswa?
Unajua, nikiwa conductor, nilikuwa naulizwa, hey, Kiki, tunakuona kwa TV na unafanya nini hapa? Nikuwa nasema natafuta pesa ya album.
Ah.
Sasa hiyo opportunity venye imekuja, mimi nimeirukia,
mm-hmm.
Pause, teeth, and yet everything. Like now, hiyo Riswa tu ni kutoa mapepo. You know me, I'm a lyrical genius, so I give catchy hooks.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Riswa is very catchy.
Drop some few bars, you know. drop some few bars. Kidogo tu.
Ya Riswa. Mm. I mean, I think yafaa ichezwe.
Sasa udrop alafu tutasink na kucheza.
sema ni Drogba zengine. Mm-hmm.
Zizi yariswa tu, most months.
Okay.
Anza na basi ya kwanza.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. Ama chorus. Straight up, guys.
Baraka zangu zikikupa stress, weka mkono juu ya kichwa. Riswa. People la kutaka nisiendele, mi sitaki fake friends, wakunitia kucha, chuna kama ufa, napanda wakishuka, what play kama sutra, I'm a hippopuka captain on my ship, in this bloody waters, and I don't give a shh, just not infect my paper. Natia bidini toke ghetto, ni by SM punguze joto, no high five, pengine ngoto, wajivu, mimi moto, I'm a baby, yeah, I'm a hot dog, and I'm so sick, walini kata hospital, yo, riswa.
Yeah, hey, baby boy, baby girl back at home watching us on your TV screens. Staki kuongea mob. Let's just listen to the track itself.